Hey everybody, welcome to the new episode of Blockchain Central. I'll be honest with you, despite being a crypto fan for some time now, I'm still a bit uncertain what hashes, hash functions, and keys really are. The hash has been described as the workhorse of a modern cryptography, and it is a core element of any blockchain. That's why in today's episode, we're going to try and break down the hash. Let's get right into it. A hash is the output of a hash function, also called a digest. That is because it is the result of computation. The computation follows the rules of a hash function. A hash function takes in a value of arbitrary size. No matter if it's a single word or a whole page of text, the function computes an output of a fixed size. So all outputs are equally long, no matter the inputs. One very simple hash function is the average checksum. Imagine splitting any number up into single characters. So for 48, it's 4 and 8. Then you take the average of these numbers and, this case, 4 plus 8 divided by 2 is 6. If you take 1,000 and use the same function, the hash is 0.25. That way, you will always get a hash between 0 and 10 for any input. This idea helps compare files, compress movies, and use blockchains. There are a lot of different hash functions for different use cases. For cryptography, we use cryptographic hash functions. The most well-known cryptographic hash function is SHA-256. What are the main characteristics of a hash function? One, it needs to be deterministic. The same input needs to generate the same output, like SHA-256 or the function we've shown before. Two, it needs to be quick. Because hashing happens so often, it should be quick. Today, we have no issues producing fast hash functions. Number three, it must work one way only. The input can generate the output, but given the output, one must not be able to generate the input. This is a special feature of cryptographic hash functions. So our previous example cannot fulfill this demand, because given an output of 5, I know that 55 is a possible input. In cryptography, this means that I have broken the code. For a computer, it is theoretically possible to reverse the input. However, the longer hash you have, the harder it becomes to solve it. Four, a small change in the input must change the output massively. Even after a minor change in the input, two outputs would look completely different. In this example, our little hash function also fails. If I change 888 to 889, the output changes from 8.0 to 8.3. It matters because otherwise breaking the hash is too easy. The SHA-256 function satisfies this criterion. For example, the word dog yields this, but the word dig yields this. Number five, it must be infeasible to find two different messages with the same hash. Again, that little hash function we've talked about before fails here. 5, 55, and 64 all have the same output, 5. This makes breaking the code easier. If there are more correct inputs, your chances of finding the correct one is higher. However, it also can lead to dramatic crashes in systems, although most hash functions are designed to decrease the possibility of two same outputs, it is still not fully achievable. Why? There is an infinite number of inputs, but the hashing function can only give a finite number of outputs because the length is set. However, we can make it less likely that, for example, a meteor crashes into Earth. Then we can consider it infeasible, which is all we need for now. Fun fact for conspiracy theorists, the NSA designed the SHA-256 and its variants, and some people suspect that they added a backdoor. Backdoors are hidden ways that they can use to break the encryption. However, nobody has since found a security flaw or backdoor. Today, 20 years after its initial release, SHA-256 is considered safe. Okay, what have we learned today? There are many different types of hashes. Cryptographic hashes are needed for blockchain encryption. Those need to have 5 properties. They need to be deterministic and fast. They must only work in one way. Reverse engineering must be infeasibly hard. Small changes to the input must change the output massively. And collisions must be super rare. Before you go, please note that this content does neither represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Happy investing!